How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm bringing you guys a quick beginner's guide just to show you around NordVPN so that you know how to use it properly and to make the best of its features. Okay, so before we begin, if you guys are interested in NordVPN, you'll find links to pricing discounts as well as the full review if you'd like to learn more about the privacy policy, speed streaming, and torrenting capabilities as well as security and features. So besides the obvious, which is the quick connect button right here, which will connect you to the closest server and, you know, the fact that you can just zoom in on any of these servers and click, you know, you can do that, or you can go through the list here and pick any of the servers manually. And you can, of course, look whatever server that you're trying. You can look it up in the search bar right here, whatever you want to connect to. So that's the obvious, right? Now, what about the other features, you know, the double VPN, unreal VPN? So let's just get through the features so that you have more of an understanding what feature you might want to use, what feature you care about or don't care about. So double VPN will give you the ability to connect to two servers rather than one for double the security. It's as simple as that, very self-explanatory. So it will double encrypt your traffic through two servers rather than one. Onion over VPN will give you the anonymity of the Tor browser as well as the security and encryption of the VPN tunneling. And peer-to-peer will be peer-to-peer specialty servers if you're trying to torrent or if you're trying to do some other peer-to-peer specialty activities. If I switch from NordLinks to OpenVPN, you will notice that I will get access to one more specialty server, which is the dedicated IP server. And dedicated IP will pretty much give you dedicated IPs rather than dynamic IPs as it is with the regular server, so that every time you connect to one of these servers, you will always get the same IP every time. And this can be pretty useful if you're trying to access your bank account from abroad. You don't want to keep using different IP addresses so that you don't risk getting blocked, or if you want to also avoid these CAPTCHA, annoying little CAPTCHA notifications that you get every time you try to access Google Chrome or whatever. You don't have to do a CAPTCHA as much. And threat protection is an advanced ad blocker. So this will stop web tracking. It will protect your device from infected files before they download to your device and damage it. It will avoid malicious ads and block malware-ridden websites. Meshnet will allow you to share files with people of your choice over the encrypted connection of NordVPN. So it's a very safe way of sharing files. And if we go to the settings here, you've got the kill switch, which will stop your internet connection when the VPN disconnects. So this will make sure that you're only going to be connected to the internet while you're secured by the VPN. Otherwise, it will disconnect the internet. The app kill switch will close selected apps when the VPN disconnects instead of disconnecting your entire connection. Split tiling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So it's a pretty useful feature if you don't want your entire connection to be routed through the VPN or vice versa. Custom DNS will give you an easy way to change your DNS, and obfuscated servers are servers you could use if you're having trouble in a censorship-heavy country. And that's pretty much it. Now that you know, let's say you are just simply trying to get, the best secure server, just go with double VPN or onion over VPN. These are very high privacy and high anonymity servers. If you're simply trying to, let's say, in my case, here I'm just trying to unblock Hulu, let's say, simply zoom into, I don't know, New York, let's say, within the States, a States server, and you're good to go. That's it. Now that I'm connected to the New York server, I can access whatever it is that is available in New York as if I'm in New York or some kind of American streaming service. So if you guys are interested in NordVPN, you'll find links to pricing discounts in the description down below, as well as a full review if you'd like to learn more about it. And also keep in mind that you do have a 30-day money back guarantee, so you can stress test NordVPN risk-free for the first 30 days. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.